Hello, hello everyone, Duke the Bump here, and I thought that for my next LP, I'd like to do a game that all of us know and love. It's a classic from the Nintendo Entertainment System, a game that needs no introduction. You know the one I'm talking about. Let's Color a Dinosaur. Color a Dinosaur was a game released at the height of the NES's popularity, 1993. It was released to rave reviews, and when it came out, it sold literally dozens of copies. It's a real chart topper. Man, that's a wacky dinosaur. Let's see if we can make a dinosaur that looks that wacky. As you can see, you have 16 dinosaurs to choose from the Stegosaurus to, this might be some sort of pterodactyl, maybe? I don't know, let's go with this dinosaur. He looks pretty tough. Now, there are two different modes that you can edit your dinosaur in. There's fixed mode, where the cursor automatically goes to every different part of the dinosaur, and free mode. I forget which button does which. Okay, A takes you to fixed mode, and you can hit B to switch between the colors here. Let's work on the sky first. I think a nice blue candy stripe sky is what we need. Of course, it has to draw orange first, because, you know, the limitations of the technology. And you can't move your cursor while it's doing this, so just enjoy watching it fill in the spaces. It's pushing the limits of the Nintendo's technology. There, isn't that lovely? I've never seen a more beautiful sky in nature itself. Okay, this looks like a good color for our dinosaur's body. Sort of a mauve texture, a denim-like texture, a mauve denim dinosaur. Hey, why not? We're the creative geniuses here. And let's give him a polka dot belly. Yeah, that's pretty good. Alright, this is turning out to be a wacky dinosaur. Let's color his toes and his feet, or the soles of his feet, rather. And give his spots a brick pattern. Wow. Man. I have never felt this creative in my life. Wait a second. I don't want to play Color a Dinosaur. What the hell am I doing? I wanted to play Mario 3. Yes, that's right. Duke of the Bump is LPing Super Mario Bros. 3. A game that needs no introduction. A classic for the Nintendo Entertainment System. Released at the height of the system's popularity in 1988, and this game sold millions of copies. I don't know how many millions exactly, but it is the most popular game released for the NES, sold the most copies. Well, not counting Mario 1, because it was released with the system, so that's cheating and doesn't count. So, I'm not going to explain anything in this game, because if you've never played Super Mario Bros. 3, then do yourself a favor, stop watching this video, just close the window right now, and then go buy a copy of Super Mario Bros. 3 somewhere. I don't care. If you have an NES, you know, you can buy a copy on eBay. Unbelievably cheap these days. Well, probably. I haven't checked lately, but, you know, there's millions of copies of the game floating around, so it can't be that expensive. They also released a version for the Game Boy Advance, which you can play on a GBA or a DS. And it recently came out for the Virtual Console earlier in November, so if you have a Wii, pick that up, because this is honestly one of the best games ever made. It's definitely the best Mario game ever made. I don't know. I mean, I have a special place in my heart for Yoshi's Island, but I mean, I think Mario 3 just beats it. I mean, for the time, it was huge. I mean, this game is unbelievably big for an NES game. I'm not sure how many hours it would take you to beat it, but I'd have to say at least 5 if you don't skip any levels. Which, by the way, I'm planning on doing. I'm not using the warp whistle at all. I might have to use the skip cloud on a couple levels in the later worlds. I'm hoping I don't have to. But if it comes down to that, I won't be ashamed. If I was playing by myself, then I could keep doing this for several minutes and build up a huge stockpile of 1-ups before I continued. I usually get about 30 or so before I keep going, but I'll stop at 9. 9's a pretty good number. And I shouldn't have gotten those coins because there's a special treat. Well, what you're supposed to do is hit this pal, turn those coins into blocks, and, you know, jump up there and grab the extra life. But, you can do it, you can fly up there, you can use your tail and float over. Man, I'm playing this game horribly. Screw it, it's just an extra life. You know it's there, because I just told you. So yeah, I guess I am going to end up describing things in this game, because otherwise, I just won't really have that much to talk about. So, this game has a special place in my heart. It was one of my favorite games as a child. I actually owned it on an NES back in the day. And, I've beaten it more times than I care to count. Dozens, I'd have to say. More than I've beaten any other game. That's for sure. And, I wouldn't call myself an expert at the game, because I'm sure there are people out there who are better than me at it. But I know where most of the secrets are, if not all, and I can play it without dying too many times, so. And there's a music block there. If you bounce on it, it bounces you up to Cloud World. But I'm not going to do it because it just takes way too long. It's boring. All this up there are some coins and a 1-up, which, you know, not to toot my own horn, but I doubt I will be needing that many 1-ups. Oh, who am I kidding? Yeah, I'm tooting my own horn. I'm good at this game. Who isn't? Everybody should be good at this game. I mean, it's not difficult. In fact, it's really easy. Except for some of the later levels, but you know. And I'll be retrieving this whistle, but I won't be using it. It's merely a curiosity. A conversation piece. I don't know if these bosses are random or not. You think I know after as nope. I mean, yep, they're random, because that one usually has a leaf in it, but this time it has a mushroom. Okay, there's a secret in level 4, which I'm able to get sometimes, not all the time. Basically, if you collect all the coins on this level, it opens up a white mushroom house, one of the rare treats in this game, where you can collect a special item. I believe the one in this world has P-Wings. And there are 1-ups scattered all over the place, if you know where they are. I'm not going to bother with all of them, but... Let's see. No coins there. I'm usually able to get all of them. There's just this one block that I have trouble with sometimes, and it's right here. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, I think that's it. I think I got it. Let's hope so. And these 3 coins at the end, I don't think there's anything over here. Check just to make sure. Okay, looking good. Let's see if I can get 5 extra lives. Nope. Not enough room to run. Okay, let's see if I got it. Yep, there it is. It is a shop of strange and wonderful things. Yep, it's the P-Wings. I'll be saving those. We're going to need them for the last couple worlds. And, yeah, we have time to do the castle. Fairly short level. There's another warp whistle here, but I'm not going to get it. We already got one. In order to get the warp whistle in this level, you fly up here, you run all the way to the right, and then you push up to enter a hidden door. But we'll be fighting... you know, I forget this guy's name. I want to think he's called Boom Boom, but I'm not entirely sure. I never really paid him that much attention. Boom boom. Oh, his parents must have hated him. He's a creepy looking dinosaur man anyway. He probably didn't have any friends. Oh, he's pissed off now. Oh, we got him. And he drops a question mark in a circle. I always thought it looked like a key, because when you get it, it breaks open a lock. That one right there. Okay, and I say that about does it for this video, and tune in next time for The Secret in Spade, which is another bonus game that I suck at, and finishing up World 1. I'm Duke of the Bum. See you guys next time.